question. Is this going a separate bucket from the other three that we put forward? Because I don't think it's fair to really support this if they're going head to head, because we already put the three forward, and I don't think it's fair to that folks to put another one in unless it's a whole different kind of a set aside or something.
This is BLM's project.
So it won't compete for any funds that the other three would be? Okay, then if that's the case, then I'm fine with it. I just want to make sure.
Is it under the PTNA?
I don't believe so. I can't remember.
Because I know we can put forward three projects and.
And then they give a letter of recommendation to us when we put forward our projects.
Right, based on what kind of assistance they would need. But I don't know if this is in the PTNA subcategory, and if it is, then it would compete against the same pool of funds for PTNA, but I'm not sure.
I don't believe that it is, Elizabeth, not from my past experience.
Maybe wait and find out.
Well, this letter needs to go in. I believe the deadline is September 14th to go ahead and submit your applications, and your letters of support have to be included.
If you want, maybe we can wait and bring this back up later in the commission meeting.
And try and get some clarification.
And try and get some clarification.
Yeah, I think that'd be great to get some clarification on this.
So Nicole, on this letter, you have Mr. Miller's phone number.
I do.
You call him and tell him we'll ask for him to participate in the meeting after, 11 or so, after some of the time.
Absolutely.
If you would do that.
I will.
Okay, we're gonna leave that blank. Then we'll go to D. Just a minute. Item D is discussion for possible action, the approval of the minutes from the following county commission meeting, August 12, 2020. Does anyone have any additions, subtractions, or corrections? Hearing none, I'll look for a motion to approve the minutes.
Motion to approve August 12 minutes.
Motion by Lori.
Second.
Second by Ian. Any further questions? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? None. So we're right on the number right here. So we're going to go back to our 9:30 timed item. And that is on page 2. This is page 2, item B. It's a 9:30 proposed ordinance from the 514 bill number 08.12.2020. Item 1 is a public hearing, discussion, third reading for possible action. The White Pine County Commission will take public comment and consider approval of a proposed ordinance 514, bill number 08.12.2020, an ordinance regulating the use of certain heavy equipment on county roads, requiring a county maintenance agreement with the county prior to the operation of certain heavy equipment on county roads, imposing criminal and civil penalties for failure to comply with this ordinance, adding a severability clause. And that's that. This is the third reading, and it's up for, there'll be some public comment if there's any on this.
So I think you actually have two of these probably on your desk right now. One of them has blue, one of them has red. The red one is the most recent one. I spoke with Bill this morning. He's a very shrewd lawyer. He had me add some language to this, so I was happy to do so. So does everybody have the red draft?
Yeah, I have the red draft.
Good.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, my concerns, I think, yeah, that looks good to me under the occasional use.
Okay.
And then we also defined user. That was kind of what Bill and I hashed out today.
Does this mean it can be done at any time?
Please. We're not, the public's not allowed to put input in here.
Well, it is a public hearing, so you can recognize them.
You're recognized. Please come forward, state your name.
Yes, my name is Christopher Nilo, and I was curious as to whether or not there's certain time frames. Can they do it all 24 hours, or does it fall into the parameters of business district and residential where there's a noise ordinance?
Meaning what can, when they can operate?
Yeah.
The purpose of this is that we had someone come in and work on doing a development project kind of out a ways. There was no consideration for how to deal with the roads, and the roads were severely damaged. So what we're putting in here is saying, from here on out, if you're coming out to do stuff in our county, you're gonna, before you start messing with roads and moving heavy equipment, you're gonna have an agreement with us that says you're fixing it. That's what's happening. That's all this is.
So it's more has to do with heavy equipment, that type of stuff, not just your standard, yeah, vehicle, people that are going out recreational, you know, taking their Sunday drive or whatever.
It's just saying, if you're gonna do business in a way that brings heavy equipment onto our county roads, you're gonna have an agreement in place that you're gonna help us to maintain it if it costs them. That's all.
So should an agreement like that also be held at the council meetings as well? That way, we all are there as witnesses to it, because I could very well just donate some of my time to go out there and see exactly how they're working it, if it falls in with how it should be done correctly. And then when we all know it, it's easier to work together and fix the issue.
This is the third reading, so this means this has been brought up before.
Okay. I think maybe to answer that, every agreement that the county would enter into would be a public record, so.
Okay, so my question being, so the other officials that aren't here or individuals that you're in contact with, us as residents of Ely are not able to go and speak with these individuals, let alone find it easy to get into the office or have a conversation with them when we all have good ideas. You know, and the more we all share with one another about what we know and how to do it, the easier it gets. That's all I'm saying, is like, maybe one day, so the road crew's out there, we all go as a community, go and see what they're talking about and hear from all perspectives. Because there's no right or wrong answer. It's all about perspective and how we can help one another.
I think the DA has explained that we have public hearings, and whenever we get ready to put enforce an ordinance, there are public hearings right here in this building that the public is allowed to come and voice their opinion or whatever. This is the third reading of this particular ordinance. So this is one that we can take an action on today, because we've had two briars. But all things, we're not gonna send the public out to things. You can come to all the public hearings, because all the decisions are made by this board. This board is.
I understand that, but in this situation where a lot of people are going stir crazy because we don't, not a lot of people, not everyone is working, excuse me. So by biding their time and learning to do something else, they're able to step outside their accustomed routines and learn to do something else, and therefore heighten their education and their communication skills with one another.
Again, come to the public hearings. Each one, there's usually two or three. Come to them, voice your opinion, do it to this board, because we made the decision. So you're welcome to come here anytime you want. Going out to the site, come to here. Here's where the decisions are made. So that's why this is on the agenda as a third reading.
For
we're
sure.
We're gonna take an action here, I think. I'll open just one.
Okay, my apologies. I'm in no qualms or disrespect.
No problem.
Thank you.
So anyone else got any comment on this? George, come forward.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Mr. Chairman, on your section 7.08-030, you added, unless such maintenance or repairs are approved by the Board of County Commissioners, taking your road crews, your equipment, and fixing a problem such as was created by Western Oil and Mining, or whatever their name is, that should be done by a contractor. Tying up your road crews to mitigate that, a quick fix is fine, but that was not a quick fix. You were looking at, I believe, $3.5 million versus $500,000 that the county doing. The county has no business taking care of a problem like that, tying up your equipment. You should be a contractor. And if they can't hire a contractor, then they need to do something else to mitigate any negative impacts on those areas. Thank you.
Thank you. Anyone else with public comment on this ordinance? Anyone on the phone? Hearing none, seeing none, any commissioner got any comments to make?
Move to approve.
Okay. Motion by Travis to approve, and second by Lori. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? None, pass unanimously.
Quickly too, I got a text message from the mayor. He is in the meeting, or he was, and he was asking that if we could do his item before 11:30, he would appreciate it.
Yeah, are you on there, Nathan? Nathan, are you on the phone?
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay, let me open it up. It's your item, just a moment, we're gonna get to it. It's on page five. It's item four under notice of unplanned items. 4A is discussion for possible action, approval to amend the lease agreement between the City of Ely, White Plain County, and the White Plain Corral Association to require the White Plain Corral Association, one, maintain public liability insurance in the amount of $2 million, aggregate $1 million per incident, and two, require all corral leases to sign waivers of indemnifying White Plain County and the City of Ely. Go ahead, Nathan.
So as you recall, some months ago, we leased out the city corrals to the White Pine Corral Association. They've been doing a great job to get this agreement up and going, which is an agreement that's already been approved by both the council and the commission. One of the items was that they needed to have liability of $5 million, a $5 million policy, which has just proven to be a little difficult to get. I'm not exactly sure why that number was stuck in there, but we did go back to COPAC and spoke with our broker and spoke with our council and as well as the DA's office. It didn't seem a reason why we couldn't lower that to a $2 million policy like it was this year. That all seems like more than enough. COPAC did suggest having that disclaimer in there, which I don't think will be a problem, but this should get them up and running a lot. Are there any questions about that?
Brian, do you have a comment on that?
I don't have a comment. I can't recall either why that number, that initial $5 million was out there. I just cannot.
Would the DA have a problem with this $2 million and $1 million?
I don't have a problem with it, no.
And the city has no problem with it either, Nathan?
No.
Okay.
Well, and the council will approve that tomorrow night.
Okay. I'm just trying to go through the motion to get this all right. So right now, based on your comment and the DA's, I'm going to ask for a motion to approve this amended lease agreement.
Motion to approve.
Motion by Lori.
Second.
Second by Shane. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? None. So there you go, Nathan.
Hey, Richard.
Thank you.
Mr. Bybee is on the phone. He might be able to answer that. Well, he was.
Answer what? The one for Mr. Miller?
Yes.
Jared, are you on the phone?
I am.
Okay, we opened up an item that was the BLM's request for a letter of support, and it was for us to send a letter of support for SNIP Round 18 for the large recreational project north of Ely by John Miller of the BLM. We looked at the backup and read the letter that Mr. Miller spoke. There was a couple of comments by the commission and a couple of questions, and one was both address the same thing. Does this fall into the category? We already prioritized our three SNIPMA round 18 projects, and we were wondering, does this fall into that? Are we trying to reopen it again, or is this just simply the BLM's project that the BLM would like to have submitted to SNIPMA for consideration? Am I right there? Am I doing okay there?
Yeah, can you reopen that item, please?
Yeah, let me reopen the item for you, Jared. It was on page five. It was item C. It was a discussion for possible action, the approval to prepare and send a letter of support for SNIP Round 18 grant proposal, by the BLM for a large recreational area, project north of Ely, and it was by John Miller, the BLM. So I kind of gave you an update of what our questions were on this. And I'd like to hear what the BLM has to say.
Okay, so this project is a
BLM submission for round 18. It is very close to town and very close to county assets there around the town. So long story short is, it is redoing Garnet Hill as well as Eagan Crest Trailhead and pulling that trailhead back off the highway and combining the two recreation areas, enhancing Garnet Hill so you can get school buses in, things like that. As well as there would probably be a phasing to it where we take the existing trail system and we add about 30 miles on all BLM roads. But we would like support from White Pine County on it simply because it is going to be greatly enhanced in the area, and it will attract probably more of a OHV crowd, as well as it will attract, with that improvement of the road, the BLM road that goes to Garnet Hill from both sides of the highways, not only Highway 50, but also the state route on the other side, that it will increase basically school groups, education type groups. We do plan on, if this proposal did get funded, that we will make that road so it is bus accessible. So we're just looking for support on going forward with that.
We just
Jared, the concern is that they were worried that it had to do with PTNA, where it would be in direct conflict of what the county has put forward. But yours is a different category, and
it is a capital improvement, yes.
So yeah, it would not compete with what we already have in place.
Right.
Yeah, so long as that's the case, I'm moved to approve.
And so, simply put, it's just us saying, yeah, go ahead, if the county's good with you submitting for the SNP one. SNP one is going to make the final decision on it anyway. But we have our priorities, and the BLM is just putting their item in, and they would like county support. And listening to the commissioners so far, I think there would be support to let you go ahead and see which one they approve, because they haven't approved ours.
This is under BLM,
right?
Category SNPLMA under capital improvement, where ours is PTNA, Parks, Trails, and Natural Area. So I will second Travis's motion.
Okay, a motion by Travis to approve and a second by Lori. Any further discussion? Anybody? Hearing none?
Yes.
All those in favor?
Aye. So I do have a question.
Sorry, but that wasn't public comment.
But it's really important because...
I'm sorry, but this is just for us to act on sending a letter.
Well, I would like to say...
I'm not going to argue with you.
Sir, you're not allowed to disrupt a public meeting. He can recognize you to speak. He did not, okay?
Okay, but it says right here in the agenda that the letter was submitted by John Miller, and we're not even talking to John Miller. It's going through another...
Okay, that's the end of the line, okay? No more interruptions. We listened, that was the BLM, and we listened to everything. No more interruptions. You can talk during public comment, and that's it. We don't debate public comment, no more. That was read. No more, sir.
One more time, I'll ask
the sheriff to remove it. One more time.
No, I can behave.
I've given him enough time. That's it. You're going to be removed from the building.
You're out.
Okay.
Here.
I'll go
on. Every year.
I couldn't leave without any altercations. I thought that was open for public right then. I thought that's what you had said, because it was the end of that. Correct?
First one.
I mean, no disrespect.
Okay. Sorry about that if anybody was offended. Go back to our 9:45 item. That item was passed unanimous. Like to say so. We are at 9:45. Item C on page 3. Item 1, it's the Mount Wheeler Power. Discussion for possible action. Approval of a security agreement with Mount Wheeler Power to provide for irrevocable letter of credit as required by USDA for the Rural Economic Development Loan and Grant App Program, REELG, as approved by Mount Leary Board of Directors, Elizabeth Francis, Director, and Kevin Robinson, Mount Leary Power. Who wants to take the lead?
I will let Kevin Robinson go ahead and tell us what came up at the board meeting yesterday, because you had the discussion with the Mount Leary Power Board yesterday.
Chairman, members of the commission, it's my pleasure. For the record, Kevin Robinson, I'm CEO with Mount Leary Power. We embarked on this journey about 3 years ago with an application to USDA for a Red Lake loan, which is Rural Economic Development Loan and Grant Program. And it is specific to cooperatives throughout the country that can apply for these funds. And this, the item that the commission and Mount Leary partnered on is a zero interest loan for $1 million to be used for the White Pine Justice Center. And we were successful in that application. During this ride, if I might just go back in history a little bit, question three, the Energy Trust Initiative put this in jeopardy. It would have eliminated cooperatives. And I think in this community, it's very essential that we have in the entire service territory that Mount Leary serves, over 16,000 square miles in two states. So I think it's essential that we were able to defeat that and maintain our existence. We are now ready to finalize and fund. I think we've come to a point where we're ready to get this on and move forward. The zero interest loan is a 10-year loan. One of the requirements is a letter of credit that Mount Leary has to post through its banker. And we were able to, because of the USDA programs, our banker allows a total separate fee structure for these types of irrevocable letters of credit. And it's reduced by 25 basis points, which is a quarter of a percent. So it's half a percent, so it's 50 basis points. And that is told on the balance owed each year. And on $1 million, so the first year would be $5,000 for the premium on that. And then it would decline down to the last year being $500. So a total of 10 years is $27,500 for the $1 million loan. I don't have a formal agreement prepared, but I believe our council's been developed that. The Mount Leary Board is would consider on an annual basis, as they are an elected board as well, they cannot obligate future boards to considerations and basically just foregoing those types of premiums, but they would be considering of any request, written request to them, to basically pay that fee on behalf of the county on an annual basis. The legislature provides Mount Leary use of the cheap capital credits, those capital credits that are sent out to members that are no longer on the system that we cannot find, and we can use those funds for the public good. So that would be where that funding would come from. We're proud to be a partner with White Pine County. This long sought after project is something that this community and this county is desperately needed. And so we're proud to be here, and I will be willing to answer any questions that you might have.
Anyone got a question? Kevin? If not, hearing none, seeing none, Elizabeth, you got anything to add to that?
I would just like to thank Mount Leary Power and Kevin Robinson very much for helping us with this loan process and making this available to us for the Justice Center project. Thank you very much.
And the commission echoes that.
Yeah,
I'm really appreciated for Mount Leary to step up and be a stakeholder.
Okay, that being said, and Kevin giving his presentation, I'm going to look for a motion to approve.
Move to approve.
Second. Motion by Shane, second by Ian. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Opposed? None. Passed. Thank you, Kevin.
Thank you.
Kevin.
Thank you.
Thanks,
Kevin.
I'll get something prepared.
5 to 10.
Thank you, Kevin.
Elizabeth, we got about 8 minutes here, so we're going to go to page 4 and try to work our way down on your project. And it's item B, department heads. First on the list is Elizabeth Francis, finance director. Item A is, and we're on page 4 for the public. Item A is discussion for possible action, the approval to proceed with negotiation with contractors for their engineering services on SNIP and Round 17 projects based on the recommendations from the evaluation committee.
Thank you, and this is on the Round 17 project, so this will be the Duck Pond, Jack Taylor Park, and I believe the last one is the Roof Mining Memorial Park. So we did receive 4 different proposals, statements of qualifications from engineers who are qualified to bid the project. Those included Basin Engineering, Civil Science, Day Engineering, and LGA Architects. And what we are asking permission to do is during an RSOQ process, you have to do something based on qualifications. Once you rank these firms, then you can go back to them and negotiate price. And so we would like permission to go ahead and start that process of negotiating price. And the firm that was ranked number one that we will be starting with is Civil Science.
Any questions by anyone on the commission? Hearing none, I'll look for a motion to approve.
Motion to approve.
Motion by Lori.
Second.
Second by Shane. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? None. Passed unanimous. Item B. This discussion for possible action, the approval of the monthly financial reports for August 2020.
I'm sorry.
If
I interrupted, I apologize.
That's okay.
Yep.
Okay, so the monthly financial reports are in your backup documentation. They are the reports for the month of August 2020. And I'm happy to answer any questions you may have. Otherwise, I ask for your approval.
Any questions by anybody? Hearing none, I'll look for a motion to approve.
Move to approve.
Motion by Ian.
Second.
Second by Shane. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? None. Passed unanimous. Item C. Discussion for possible action, the approval of Resolution 2020-53 to augment the general fund from unanticipated and unbudgeted beginning fund balance of $25,108 to provide for J&A consulting services budgeted in the FY 2020, which became due and payable in FY 2021.
Thank you. On this agenda item, I apologize. I did submit these agenda items, and I did not have the resolutions attached to them, so I handed them out to you this morning, and I apologize for that oversight. Basically, you did approve at your February 12, 2020 meeting to go ahead and allow J&A Consulting to help with the process of securing debt service for the Justice Center project. And we went ahead and did a resolution in FY 2020 to provide for money from contingency to cover the cost. Because of various hurdles on the road to getting the debt service completed, this didn't become due and payable until FY 2021. So the money remained unspent in FY 2020, reverted to fund balance, and is now available for us to appropriate in FY 2021. So I'm asking for your approval to go ahead and do that.
Any questions by anybody? If not, I'll look for a motion to approve.
I move to approve resolution number 2020-53.
Motion by Lori.
Second.
Second by Ian. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? None. Item D. Discussion for possible action, approval of resolution 2020-54 to augment the capital improvement fund from unanticipated unbudgeted beginning fund balance by $7,900 to provide for Sunrise Engineering Services on the Heritage Park project as approved by the County Commission.
Thank you. And on your August 12, 2020 meeting, you went ahead and you approved for us to move forward with obtaining professional engineering services to assist with the nomination for the Heritage Park project under Round 18 of SNPLMA. And the amount was $7,900, and we were going to go ahead and take that from Capital Improvements Fund, beginning fund balance, but I do need to do a formal resolution to get that done properly and submitted to the Department of Taxation. So I'm asking your approval for the funding for the engineering services previously approved.
Okay, any questions by anybody? Seeing none, I'll look for a motion to approve.
Move to approve.
Motion by Shane.
Second.
Second by Ian. Any further discussion? All those in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? None. That's unanimous. Item E, discussion for possible action, the approval of resolution 2020-55 to augment McGill Town Council Fund from unanticipated and unbudgeted beginning fund balance by $18,000 to provide for increased water costs for the parks, backflow preventer, and equipment to maintain the McGill ball field.
And if I may just have a